Do you guys have any doubts from the last class?
No, sir.
All right. Let's wait a few minutes for this to join. All right. Give me 2 minutes. All right, everyone. I hope you have no doubts. Does anyone have any doubts of the last classes we did?
No, sir.
You guys finished the NCRT in that exercise, particular functions?
So a few questions are left.
Few questions are left. All right. So today's topic is partial fraction. This is also very important. All right. So first thing you need to know about this is partial fraction is not a way to do integration. It is a way to simplify the functions. All right. The first thing you need to remember this. This is not a way to integrate. We have learned how to integrate. All right. This is just a method to simplify the functions. Which functions? Rational functions. And what are rational functions? P of x upon q of x. Polynomial upon polynomial functions are called rational functions. All right. You must know this, that if degree of P of x is more than degree of Q of x. What is degree?
Power to the equation.
Highest power of the variable, right?
Yes, sir.
If degree of P of x is more than degree of Q of x, then it is called improper fraction. Right? Otherwise, it is a proper fraction. We did questions regarding this, when numerator, the degree of numerator is more, then what we did in the last class, I told you about this.
We divided denominator with the numerator.
Absolutely. So we can write this 2 plus r upon d, right? I hope everyone remember this. Sayed, Kulsum, Ronaldo, Shikani. Yes or no? All right. Now what happens when degree of this is less? First note it down, please. Yep. Tell me when you are done.
Done, sir.
All right. So where does partial fraction help us? If you have a question like this, 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2. You have to integrate this. Right. So we have not seen any functions like this. This we can like multiply and solve as quadratic equation, but this question is going to be more trickier. Right. This type of functions can be simplified using partial fraction. How? We can write it like this. X plus 1, this is x plus 2. Can I write it as x plus 2 minus x plus 1 whole divided by x plus 1 into x plus 2? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So now I can separate this. This is x plus 2 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 minus x plus 1 into x plus 2 is cancelled, x plus 1 is cancelled. Sorry, this is x plus 1. So the function becomes integration of 1 upon x plus 1 minus integration of 1 upon x plus 2. These you know how to integrate, right?
Yes, sir.
Everyone is clear? Sayed, Kulsum, Ronaldo, Shikani. Yes or no? Not in the speaking zone again. No worries. And questions like this, where the difference is 1 or 2, like any number, you can always simplify like this. Try to solve one question. 1 upon x plus 5, x plus 6. Integrate this one. I'll give you a few minutes. All right, Krishna. Everyone else, Ronaldo, Shigani, Kulsum, Saeed. All right, what we can do here, we can write this as integration of this is x plus 6 minus x plus 5 whole divided by x plus 6 into x plus 5 dx. So this is integration. If you open this, this is 1 upon x plus 5 minus 1 upon x plus 6 dx. So this integration is log mod x plus 5 minus log mod x plus 6 plus c. All right, very simple, not very difficult. Now this thing is very easy. If the difference is 1, you can easily separate like this, but this is not always the case. We have to memorize these things. All right, all the types. For this first one, if you have px plus q upon x plus a into x plus b, something like this, then what you will have to do, you have to assume this function as a upon x plus a plus b upon x plus b. This is the standard assumption. All right, you cannot take anything else, just assume the functions like this. We'll solve a question, you will get to know what to do after this, but always know this: if something is like this is written, then you have to assume the function like this. Then only you can find the value of a and b. All right. If you have px square plus qx plus r upon x plus a, x plus b, and x plus c, then you have to assume this as a upon x plus a plus b upon x plus b plus c upon x plus c. All right, standard assumption is given. Please write it down. You have to memorize this. Tell me when you are done. You can change this to minus also, plus minus. Same thing.
Done, sir.
All right, everyone is clear about this?
Sir, even if the sign changes in the denominator, there will be no change in the product?
No. If you have minus, then you will have to write minus. All right. Whatever there is in the denominator, you have to write according to that. All right.
Okay, sir.
Everyone is done writing this? All right, I'll take that. Yes, write down the question. Integration x minus 1 upon x plus 1 x minus 2 dx. Write it down. Can anybody tell me what will you assume this function as?
A by x plus 1 plus b by x minus 2.
Absolutely correct. All right. After writing this step, everything is very simple. What you have to do, this is x minus 1, x plus 1, x minus 2 equals 2. Take LCM here. X plus 1, x minus 2. This is a times x minus 2 plus b times x plus 1. Right? Very simple, taking LCM. Now what we can do? This thing are cancelled. So what we have, x minus 1 equals to a times x minus 2 plus b times x plus 1. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This is equals to x minus 1 equals to ax minus 2a plus bx plus b. So this is equals to x minus 1 equals to make x together and constants together. So I can write this as a plus b times x minus 2a plus b. And in the previous class, we saw how to simplify this or how to find the value of a and b, compare the coefficients of x and the constants. Here the coefficient of x is a plus b, here is 1. So a plus b equals to 1. Here the value of constant is minus 2a plus b, here is minus 1. Right? Now we can subtract these two. This is solving the equations. So a plus 2a, b and b are cancelled, equals to 1 plus 1 is 2. So a will be 2 by 3. If a is 2 by 3, then b will be 1 by 3. Now what we can do, again we can write the same function. At x minus 1 upon, what was the question? X plus 1 into x minus 2. And this will be equal to 2 by 3 x plus 1 plus 1 by 3 x minus 2. And you can integrate this function very easily. Is everyone clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Note it down. Everyone is clear. Ronaldo, Kulsum, Saeed, very important topic. You will get one question from this and definitely you will get one question, right? Integration is divided into three parts. This is the second part. Note it down and find the final answer also. All right. I need everyone's answer.
Done.
All right, I did not receive anyone's answer except Krishna's. Ronaldo, Sayed, Kulsum, Shigani. Have you solved this? All right, I'll take that as a yes. Try to solve this question. Integration 2x plus 1 whole divided by x plus 1 x minus 2 dx. All right.
Yes, sir.
And for this, I need everyone's answer. All right, Ronaldo, Kulsum, Sayed, Shagani. All right, Krishna. All right, Sayed. All right, Ronaldo. All right, Shikani, do I need to solve this?
Yes, sir.
All right. See, we can solve 2x plus 1 upon x plus 1 into x minus 2. Again, the assumption would be a upon x plus 1 plus b upon x minus 2. Right, Shikani? So 2x plus 1 upon x plus 1 x minus 2 equals to, taking LCM, a times x minus 2 plus b times x plus 1 upon x plus 1 x minus 2. Now comparing 2x plus 1 equals to ax minus 2a plus bx plus b. So 2x plus 1 equals to x a plus b minus 2a plus b. Now solving two equations, comparing the coefficients of x, a plus b will be 2, and minus 2a plus b will be equals to 1. If you subtract these two, so a plus 2a will be 3a, b and b are cancelled, 2 minus 1 is 1, a is 1 upon 3. If a is 1 upon 3, then b will be 5 upon 3. All right, now you can just put the value. So 2x plus 1 upon x plus 1, x minus 2 will be equals to 1 upon 3, x plus 1 plus 5 upon 3, x minus 2. And you can integrate this very easily, right, Shikani? This is log of 1 upon 3 log of mod x plus 1 plus 5 upon 3 log of x minus 2 plus c. All right, note it down. Tell me when you're done. I'll give you 2 minutes. Hello, Ishan.
Yes, sir.
Again, you are late. Please come on time. You are missing important things. All right. You also note it down. All right. So that you can watch the lecture and understand what we did. Shikani, tell me when you have noted this down.
Then, sir.
All right. Let's solve another question. Integration 2x minus 1 dx whole divided by x minus 1 x plus 2 x minus 3. Can anybody tell me what to assume here? 2x minus 1 upon x minus 1 x plus 2 x minus 3 will be equal to what?
A mean? By x minus 1 plus b by x plus 2 plus c by x minus 3.
Now what will be the next step?
We take the LCM and cancel the denominators.
Absolutely. So LCM is this. This will be a into x plus 2, x minus 3, plus b into x minus 1, x minus 3, plus c into x minus 1, x plus 2. So we can write it like this, 2x minus 1 equals to a times x plus 2 x minus 3 plus b times x minus 1 x minus 3 plus c times x minus 1 x plus 2. Now there are two ways to find the value of a, b and c. All right, first you already know comparing all the coefficient of x square, x and constant. Solving three equations, you will get the value, but that is a long process. There is a trick also. A trick has some few limitations. We'll see where the limitations are. What you can do, you can put values of x, right? Because this thing is equal to this for all the values of x. So you can put any value of x and find the value of a, b, and c. So if you put x equals to minus 2, so this thing becomes 0, this thing becomes 0. So you will get directly with the value of b, right? Here x equals to minus 2, here x equals to minus 2. These thing and this thing will be 0. You'll get the value of b. Same way, you can put the value of x as 3. This will become 0, this will become 0. You'll get the value of c. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If you put x equals to 1, this will become 0, this will become 0. You'll get the value of a. Is everyone clear about this?
Yes, sir.
All right, so find the value of a, b and c. Let me solve 1. If I put x equals to 1, LHS becomes 2 minus 1 equals to a times 1 plus 2, 3. 1 minus 3 is minus 2 plus b into 1 minus 1 is 0 plus c into 1 minus 1 is 0. So 1 equals to minus 5 or minus 6 a. So a will be equal to minus 1 upon 6. So this is very simple process. You can find all the values like this. Try solving for b and c. The concept is clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
All right, note it down from the first. Tell me the final answer, everyone. All right, say Krishna, Ronaldo, Shikani, Kulsum. All right, Krishna. Ronaldo, Kulsum, are you able to solve this? Shikani? Let's see. We got the value of a as minus 1 upon 6. Now, if we put x equals to minus 2, we will have this is minus 5 equals to 0 plus minus 3. V times minus 3 into minus 5 plus 0. Thank you. all right, Mando. So this is equals to minus 5 equals to 15b. This implies p equals to minus 1 by 3. Now if you put x equals to 3, we'll have 5 equals to 0 plus 0 plus c into 2 into 5. So c will be half. Can anybody tell me the equation that will be formed putting the value of a, b, and c?
So after integration?
No, no, before integration. The replacement.
So minus 1 by 6 by 6, I mean x minus 1.
X minus 1 plus, sorry, minus 1 by
3. Minus 1 by 3, x minus 2.
All right.
Plus 1 by 2, x minus 3.
X minus 3. All right. So now we have to integrate this. Very simple. Negative 1 by 6 is bahar. And log of x minus 1 mod minus 1 by 3 bahar. Log x minus 2 plus 1 by 2 bahar. Log x minus 3. I hope everyone is clear about this. All right. If you want, note it down. I'll give you 2 minutes. From here. All right. So we have done questions based on two types. What is the next type of questions you will see? Px plus q upon x minus a whole square. All right. Px plus q upon x minus a whole square. How to write this? A upon x minus a plus b upon x minus a whole square. All right. This is the standard assumption you have to choose. And what if they give you like this? Px square plus qx plus r upon x minus a whole square into x minus b. Then what you have to do? A upon x minus a plus b upon x minus a whole square plus t upon x minus b. Note it down. These are standard assumptions. I don't write this as of now. Just assume this. All right. Do not forget this. Memorize this. Otherwise, you will not be able to solve questions. If you have noted this down, then solve one question. Integration 3x plus 1 upon x minus 2 whole square x plus 2. And in this question, while solving a, b and c or a and b, do not try to use that trick. All right, the trick will not be very useful. You can find two values using that trick, but the third one you have to find using the longer method. I hope this is clear.
Yes, sir.
All right, try to solve this. I'll give you a few minutes. All right, everyone solving it? Krishna, Ronaldo?
Yes, sir, just a minute.
All right. All right, Krishna. So how to solve this? Very simple. The assumption here would be 3x plus 1 upon x minus 2 whole square. X plus 2 will be equal to a upon x minus 2 plus b upon x minus 2 whole square plus c upon x plus 2. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. Now what we have to do, this is 3x plus 1 upon x minus 2 whole square, x plus 2 equals taking LCM. So x minus 2 whole square, x plus 2, here a into x minus 2 plus b plus c into x minus 2 whole square. So this implies 3x plus 1 equals to a times x minus 2. I think I missed this x plus 2 here. B times x plus 2 plus c times x minus 2 whole square. Now we can put x equals to 2 here. So this becomes 0 and this becomes 0. All right. So if I put x equals to 2, then this becomes 7 equals to 0 plus 4b plus 0. So b equals to 7 upon 4. Right?
Yes, sir.
Now how to find the other values?
Say you didn't multiply x plus 2 to a.
Let me Yes, I think I missed here also. X plus 2. Absolutely correct, Krishna. Thank you. All right, how we can find the other value? We can put x equals to minus 2. So this becomes 0, this becomes 0.
Yes.
So if you put x equals to minus 2, this becomes minus 6 plus 1, minus 5. Equals to 0 plus 0 plus c into minus 2 minus 2 minus 4 square is 16. So c will be equals to minus 5 upon 16. Now to find the value of a, we have no input of x, right? So what we have to do, we have to compare. We have to use the long form. So this is the limitations of this trick. So what we have to do, 3x plus 1, opening this. This is x minus 2, x plus 2 is x squared minus 4.
So we can substitute x is equal to 0, right?
X equals to 0. Yes, you can do that also. You are getting the value of x equals to 0. Yes, you can do that.
Yes, sir.
And putting the value of b and c, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you can do that also, or you can compare. So x squared minus 4 plus px plus 2p plus cx minus 2c. You can do that also. Put x equal to 0. That is, I think, is the easier method. Let me solve this also side by side. If you put x equals to 0, this becomes 1 equals to a, and this is 0. And minus 4 plus 2p minus 2c. Put b and c, you'll get the value of a as, what are you getting? The value of a.
Sir, how you got minus 2c, sir? It's...
x is 0, sorry, this will be 4c. Plus 4c, right?
Yes.
So what is the value of a?
So 5 by 16.
5 by 16. So can you tell me the replacement? Like replacement function? A upon that. So 5 upon 16 upon x minus 2.
X minus 2.
All right. And the value of b is?
So plus 7 by 4 x minus 2 whole square.
And
minus 5 by 16 x plus 2.
Now you can integrate this, I hope. All right, everyone, this thing is clear. Ronaldo, Kulsum, Saeed, Shikhani, Ishan. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
All right, please note it down. I'll give you a few minutes. Note it down. All right. I believe everyone is done about this. Last type of partial fractions that you need to know. If you have px square plus qx plus r divided by x minus a into x square plus bx plus c. Okay. This will be equal to a upon x minus a plus bx plus c upon x square plus bx plus c. And remember this, this is non-factorizable, or whatever they say is the right word. Right, it cannot be factorized further. Right, because if you can factorize this, then this will become x minus b x minus c. That is already a type we have learned how to solve. All right, so if the quadratic equation in the denominator cannot be factorized any further, then you have to use this assumption. All right, clear?
Yes, sir.
Note it down, then try to solve one question. Three upon x plus 2 into x square plus 4. This is 8. 8 upon x plus 2, x square plus 4. I'll give you a few minutes, try to solve this. I need everyone's answer in this. All right. So what to assume here? What to assume here?
A by x plus 2 plus px plus c by x square plus 4.
Absolutely. Now just taking LCM. So 8 by x plus 2, x square plus 4 equals to 8 times x square plus 4 plus px plus c times x plus 2. Upon x plus 2 to x square plus 4. So we have 8 equals to 8 times x square plus 4 plus px into x plus 2 plus c into x plus 2. So we can just open the brackets and compare, right? No need to use a lot of tricks here. So ax square plus 4a plus bx square plus 2b plus cx plus 2c. So 8 equals to a plus b x square plus cx plus 4a plus 2b plus 2c. So coefficient of x must be 0, right? So c we have got 0 and a plus b is also 0 because we have no coefficient of x square. So a equals to minus b and 4a plus 2b plus 2c must be 8. 2c is 0 and we already know b is minus a. So 2a equals to 8. So a equals to 4. So b equals to minus 2. Now you can integrate and get the answer. Yes or no? Everyone, this is clear?
So we can take x as minus 2 and then 0, right?
Yes, you can do, but like not very difficult to solve using comparison also, right?
So in that case, I'm getting a is equal to 1 and c is equal to 2 and b is equal to minus 3.
If I did something wrong or you did something wrong, we have this equation. You put x equals to
-2.
8 equals to 1 you are getting. How is this happening?
Yes, I got. I think I did some mistake.
All right. So, remember this, whenever you have quadratic equation in the denominator, right? So, it's better to compare always. All right. So, tricks are, you know, like tricks. Methods are methods. So, whenever you see quadratic equation in the denominator, try to use the comparison method. You can see this is also not very lengthy, right?
Yes, sir.
So everyone is clear? Ronaldo, Sayed, Kulsum, Shikani, Ishan. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
All right. So in the next class, we'll be taking a test of integration. All right. And please complete this, the exercise of partial fraction also. Ask me if you have any doubts in the next class. All right. This is all for today's class, guys. Take care.
So the test will be until partial fractions?
No. Before this.
Okay.
Using trigonometric identities or something like that.